drive-bys and all this different kind of stuff, engaging in games, engaging in drug selling so they can get by. We need to change our state of mind, especially when it comes to our children.
Amen.
Because our children are our inheritance. And if we don't do anything, then our children will go by the wayside. And then we will have nothing to leave. We will have no legacy to leave behind. If somebody's saying, well, I don't need a legacy, yes, you do. Because that's what God wants us to have.
Yes.
He wants us to leave a legacy. So we should be training up our children so they could do greater things than we did.
Yes.
They can exemplify what the kingdom of God is about.
Right.
But we don't teach them about the kingdom of God.
Right.
We'll teach them how to make a mighty dollar, but we don't teach them about the kingdom of God. It's amazing to me. My 3-year-old can learn a song in one, as soon as it plays, she learns it. But when it comes to the Word of God, it's like, okay, what was that again? How can you do that? It's because the things of the world, they grasp those things easily.
Yeah.
But one thing about God, we have to continue. Like they said in Deuteronomy, put it on the doorpost. Put it everywhere they can see it. Let their eye gates see it. Let them hear it. They already know. When I come to watch TV, we watching the Word Network. So everybody leave. They don't want to watch the Word Network. They want to watch something else. But that's okay. Even with, and I teach them how to pray because that's what my grandmother did for me. I remember my grandmother being at her house and she was in a room and I could hear it like she was talking to somebody. And me and my sister LaSonia were looking at each other and I'm like, there's nobody in there. So we're peeping around the corner. She came back and said, there's nobody in here.
Yep.
And then I guess my grandmother heard us because she looked up and she said, come on in. So when we came in, she continued to pray. And when she finished, she explained to us, she said, I was praying, I was talking to the Father. And she explained to us what prayer was about. And at that time, we didn't understand, but I am so grateful for a praying grandmother. Because I know that it was her prayers that kept us. It's her prayers that are even keeping us right now. And she taught me those things. Did she have her flaws? Yes. And we all do. But she taught me about God. And she told me that Jesus was the answer to everything that I needed. And I began to buy into that. So as I got older, I began to use that prayer for everything. And I had a friend to ask me, she said, why every time I ask you something, it's pray? I said, because that's all I know. I don't know anything else. I can tell you what sounds good to you. I can tell you what will feel good to you. But that's not what God is calling me to tell you. And that's what I'm telling you today. We need to get back to the basics. We need to do those things that will leave us to be unmovable. If you're saved with God, Is your bed going to be in hell or is it going to be in heaven? You don't have to answer the question to me, but to God, because he knows, and he knows. And in that, you know, God is showing us that this is a time where we need to be really, really. We really need to know without a shadow of doubt that we know God. And God wants to help us with all our flaws, because we have flaws. But my thing is, I'm coming, God. I'm giving it to you every Sunday, every Tuesday. That's when we have our Bible study. Every Tuesday, I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to let you work on me. I'm going to let you work on my mouth. Because God has taught me how to shut that mouth.
But God is saying that in order for you to get what he needs you to be,
can tell. Only God can do that. I'm not bragging. I'm speaking about what God can do. And that's what God wants to do. Many of you have children now that are very anointed, but you have brushed them off because they were different. But when your children speak, whatever God desires for you, because if he can use a donkey, I know he can use a child. Whatever God desires for you, that's why it's important that you know the voice of God. Know the voice of God, because you don't want to miss God in this day and time. Because the times that we're living in, they're perilous times. There's wars and rumors of wars. There's violence, temptations. There's earthquakes in diverse places. God is speaking, but who's listening? He's speaking. He's speaking. Even in a wind, God speaks. Even in a wind, he speaks. So I'm telling you as a people, we better wake up and realize that the end is close. But we better be in a place. Because God said, whatever you're doing when he comes back, keep on doing. Keep on doing. So that's why he can't have you straddle a fence. Because if you hide a pole, he can deal with you. But straddle, he don't even know. He don't even know. God is like, I don't even know. They don't even know. But for such a time as this, I admonish you to understand and hear the voice of God. To know the things of God, to operate. It is so important to let liberty be in the place. It's so important because God moves in liberty. He not messed up about our agenda, because some of y'all looked at the clock already and said, we should have been out of here. But God is not messed up about that. God is wanting to reach people because his desire is that none will perish. But some will perish because they cannot hear the voice of God. They do not obey what's coming from the voices of God. So, I mean, what can God do? He allows us to have a choice. He gives us choice. Who will you choose? As Joshua said, for me and my house, who will
she didn't like it. She could see the light.
light, and she knew she was in darkness. So you, that light was calling her to make a choice. And she thought she was going to put my light out. I said, no, darkness has to go when light comes in. And that's what happened. She had to leave. She had to leave. I had a few scriptures that I wanted to read, but I'm just saying God be God right now. Okay. I don't plan to be this for you. If you'll turn to me with me.